Hello everyone and welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, my name is Sasha and I normally do videos with my daughter Arella, who is 2 years old. Today's video, I'm going to be talking about some different tips on how to raise an only child. So I am a mom to an only child. I don't plan on having any more kids, and if you've seen my previous video on why I don't want other kids, you'll know why I don't. A lot of people do say things like they'll be lonely or spoiled or bratty and just a bunch of different things like that. So I am trying to implement a lot of these in my routine with my daughter now so that she is more independent and she grows up to be very successful and happy. Without further ado, I'm gonna jump into today's video, and starting with number one, this is just spending quality time with them and having fun. So just tapping into your inner child and laughing, enjoying, having a good fun time. This will just make sure that they are laughing and you know you're laughing and you're having a good time. Number two is leading by example. So you want to be the role model that you want them to follow. So things like sharing and being compassionate and being kind, showing them what it is to be a nice, kind human. They aren't dealing with their siblings and stuff, so by leading in this example that you want them to follow and stuff, they're seeing things that you're doing and then copying those things. Especially little kids, like toddlers, they see everything that you do, and leading by example will cause them to follow these good habits and make them a routine in their own life. Number three is setting clear boundaries. So a lot of the times only kids tend to like get their way and stuff like that, and if you're having a conversation with someone else, they might tend to speak up or act out really loudly and think that they're the center of attention and they're just used to getting their own way. And I think a great thing is setting these boundaries and making sure they understand that, okay, it's my turn to talk and I'm doing my own thing, and they have their own independent time, so they're not always butting in and being disrespectful and acting like one of the adults in a sort of way, so thinking that they can do things that they're not supposed to just because they're the only one and they're used to getting their way. So making sure to set these clear boundaries and letting them know, this is my time, my conversation, no, you're not gonna butt in, adults are talking, or, you know, I'm gonna do my own thing now, you're gonna do your own thing, and they should understand that. So setting these clear boundaries and then being consistent. Another tip is not interfering too much. So just letting them be their own person and not trying to build this whole agenda for them, like, okay, you're gonna get into all these activities and do all these things. Don't get me wrong, it's great to get them involved in things, but just making sure that you're not putting too much onto them. So for example, like trying to do things that you wish you did as a kid, or wanting to do better but then you put too much onto them. Just letting them be their own person, figuring out things that they like, and then going based off that. That's why it's great to do a lot of Montessori style learning, so then you see the type of person that they are and how they like learning and the different things that they're good at, that they get frustrated with, and that they just enjoy doing, and going based off that. Just not trying to shape them and make them become someone that you wanted to be or anything like that. Another thing is social interactions with others and encouraging it. So this is a great way for them to spend time away from you and learning proper social cues and social interactions from others. So just being in a social setting around other people and learning things like, I can't butt in when they're talking, or sometimes other kids might not let me play with their toys and I have to learn how to share, or it depends if they want to share. I might not always get my way because the rules are different here. So they learn a lot of different things that you can't teach them, you know, in a single child household. It's good for them to get these different interactions so that they're learning based off of different people and just learning how to behave well in a social manner. A lot of the times they'll learn and follow different social cues and stuff, so it's just a great thing to get them to interact with others. Another tip that I have is when buying gifts or clothing or toys or anything, don't overindulge and get too much. It's really easy to go overboard and get excessive amount of toys and clothing and gifts, but this just kind of gives them the idea that they will get everything that they want and they're used to getting everything that they kind of see, and they know that they got a lot of things their way. By limiting it, it kind of shows them the value of things, and there's a lot better things than getting them a bunch of clothing and toys anyways, and a lot of the times it is a waste because with toys they will not play with a lot of them, clothing they grow out of it, and just a lot of more pros than cons with getting less gifts than bombarding them with gifts. And along with that, I would say compliments and excessive, just overindulging with the wows and you did a great job and like filling their head up with so much. It's great to compliment them and make sure your child is confident and feeling really happy with the way they're doing things and feeling accomplished and wow, like mom noticed and I did a great job. But going overboard and complimenting everything they do and just giving them this sense of like they need to do everything perfect, or like I do everything perfect, so like don't try to tell me how to do it, because you know, my mom, I grew up thinking like everything was wow, great job. Just balancing it out, giving it in, you know, moderation, but just not overdoing the compliments and boosting up their ego and head too much. You just don't want that kind of energy or like snappy kind of bratty attitude from them. And yeah, here's some. If you guys have an only child and you have other tips that work with you and things to avoid like that bratty, spoiled, entitled kind of feeling, feel free to drop it down in the comments below. I love learning other things because I don't plan on having another kid for a long time or at all. These are just some tips that I have learned and I found work with dealing with an only child. And I think it's beneficial to start it early just so they don't grow up feeling bratty or spoiled or, again, lonely, like that spending time with them like you are their only friend, and you want to make sure that they're having fun, like they don't have that sibling to joke around with and play with, so goof around and they'll love that. It makes their relationship with the parent so much stronger, and again, like they won't feel that lonely only child feeling. So yeah, I think it's a great thing to, you know, put your phones away, put everything away, and just be a kid with them when you go to the park, actually going up and going down the slide and playing with the sandcastles and doing all that stuff, just taking the time to actually have one-on-one, and they'll be a lot more independent. I find like on days that I don't, you know, spend a lot of time with my daughter one-on-one, she's more clingy and she wants to be around me all the time. But if I take that time to have quality time with her and I put all distractions away, I spend my time with her and we sit there and we do quality things together, she's good having that time alone. She actually enjoys it and she'll be fine. Like she has fun by herself because she had enough time with me, and we still continue to do things throughout the day, but it's just not quality things. Like it's basic necessities, and it's not that learning about what they like and how they are, and you just learn so much from just sitting there and spending that time with them. Let go and do things with them, and it feels good for you too. It's just mindlessness. But yeah, that is the end of today's video. That's all the tips that I have. If you haven't already, don't forget to check out our other videos. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.